a lot about sun these days because we're seeing a lot of it. And while many people slather on the sunscreen, some forget about their eyes. In today's House Calls, Dr. Shailesh Kaushal, the chair of the Department of Ophthalmology at UMass Memorial Medical Center, joins us live via Skype. Doctor, thank you for joining us this afternoon.
Thank you.
Well, what kind of damage can the sun do to your eyes?
So it's interesting, the sun exposure, extended sun exposure, can have an effect on the ability of the eye to produce tears. It can sometimes affect the cornea. It can even, in prolonged instances, induce cataracts. And the most significant potential injury from excessive sunlight exposure is to the retina itself, the photographic film of the eye.
What does it do to the retina?
In some instances, those people who are, let's say, out on the water where there's reflected light, or, for example, skiers as well in wintertime where there's reflected light off the snow, it can affect that area of central good vision. And among other things, even though we don't have those occasions right now, people who stare at the sun can directly burn the area of central good vision as well.
So does it just damage your eyesight, or is it reversible?
That's an excellent question. The changes that can occur in the front part of the eye with respect to tears or the cornea, those are usually reversible. The retina, injuries to the retina or to the lens, i.e. cataract formation, those are usually not reversible. But fortunately, those occur very rarely.
So how long or how often do you have to stay outside before risking some damage to the eyes?
Another very good question. It depends on the type of sun exposure. Just like everything else in life, you know, a little bit is good, too much is not so good. So what we always recommend folks to try to minimize direct sunlight exposure when they're outside, especially those, say, for example, who in the summer are out on the water. It's always good to have some type of eye protection.
So many people look for fashion when they choose sunglasses. What else should they be looking for?
That's another wonderful question. Polarized sunglasses are very effective in protecting the eyes from any damage from sunlight itself. And what we typically recommend is folks should pick those polarized sunglasses which are dark enough for them to see what they need to do, but obviously not so dark that they can't negotiate or get around.
So what can people do with small children?
That's also very important, especially in the summer when kids are out from school. It's important for children who are going to be out on the water or near the water, or out, let's say, at camps, to wear caps, be it baseball caps or other sun caps, to minimize, again, the amount of direct sunlight in the eye.
Are those people who wear contacts at greater risk?
No, not really. Again, the same advice we offer them is to wear a baseball cap or a sun cap, sun hat, to minimize the amount of direct sunlight exposure.
Okay. Well, thank you for joining us this afternoon.
You're very welcome.
Well, if you have a question about a medical issue, email us at housecalls@cbs3springfield.com, and we will ask a doctor during one of these live Skype interviews in-house.